this video, I'm going to make strawberry jam from scratch. This is my second attempt ever at making it. My first attempt didn't turn out so well. I used a recipe I found online the first time that did not include pectin. I thought that was odd, but I tried it anyway. And it ended up very strange. Just something about it didn't taste right. So I decided to try again on camera. Did this time turn out? I won't spoil the surprise. I did use a different recipe this time that does call for pectin. You will see later in the video. But the first thing it recommends is to pour the sugar pre-measured once it's time to add the sugar. So I started by pre-measuring it. And I don't know if you are keeping track, but that is 7 cups of sugar in that bowl. Never realized just how much sugar is in jam until I made it. I suppose that's what makes it so. I have no idea if this recipe will work for other fruits, but my first goal was to make strawberry jam. Where I live right now, strawberries are in season, which means not only are they red, ripe, and yummy, most of the time. So along with our 7 cups of sugar, this recipe calls for 5 cups of strawberries, which I find even funnier that the sugar is technically the number one. Even more so than strawberries. But again, that's why jam is so good. If you've watched my other recipe videos, you know that I love to chop and slice fruits and veggies. Strawberries are no exception. I use a small paring knife it all just in my hand. Slide my thumb across the knife, the dull end of the knife, in order to get the tops off. Some people use a spoon or a grapefruit spoon. Others stab through the strawberry with a straw to get the leaves off. Again, you know, if you've watched my other videos, a knife is the way to go. That might make me sound kind of violent, but I promise I'm not. There's something therapeutic about cutting a fruit or a vegetable to me. I do not feel the same way about me. In fact, I hate cutting meat, raw or cooked, if I can help it. My husband is still. What I really wanted to do for this recipe was find a pick-your-own strawberry farm. I had been to one before, but it was in another state than I live in now. And so I looked and found a farm that does that very thing. But since it is late in the summer, their website said they were picked completely dry. So these are from the grocery store. But they're still really good. I'm a big fruit eater. My friends at work who eat lunch with me comment on how much fruit I eat every day. I tell them it's not even hard for me. I crave it. I love it. Practically all kinds. A few years ago, I invested in a Vitamix blender. Expensive, but so worth it. And in my opinion, it's paid for itself many times over, because before I had that blender, I would use way less expensive blenders just from the store. And they would break after a couple of months. suppose I've had it about 4 or 5 years. And it still works like day one. So. Anyway, a lot of times on a work day, my breakfast will be a fruit smoothie. And then lunch will be fruit to snack on. And then my snack will be fruit. And then it's not until I get home and have dinner that I have a more substantial meal. I love summertime where I am because it means berries, watermelon, grapes. For me, it's difficult when you have to measure out citrus juice when you're squeezing it out of the fruit. So I'm just gonna squeeze two juicy ones into a bowl and measure them, the 4 tablespoons out afterwards. Now there are also many, many ways of getting the juice out of a lemon. One of them is what I just did. Squeeze it with your own two hands, hard as you can. And then this tool works to get the other juice out. Much. So that's what works for me, is hands and then some sort of tool. Some people stick a knife in there and squeeze. I do that sometimes, but it seems dangerous. But anyway, it's a good idea. Roll it out with your hands until it feels nice and squishy. Because the squishy means you've loosened up the juices. Another thing you could do, if your citrus is just not squishy, no matter how much you roll it, is put it in the microwave for 20 seconds maybe. your strawberry mixture is gently boiling, add the ginormous bowl of sugar and thoroughly combine it. This took quite a lot of stirring. Then you let it come up to what the recipe calls a violent
Mm-hmm.